Just one. 1 week until the 2018 college football season kicking off. It's kind of been a long off season for me. Those of you that have kind of stuck around all year long, college football, the number one sport to talk about, is back. For those of you that have taken the off season off away from my channel, welcome back and strap yourselves in for another great college football season. Season 4 of Johnny Talk Sports. I didn't think I'd make it this far. Season 1, I really thought this whole channel idea was going to be a bust. But Seasons 2 and 3 saw major improvement. Is there more improvement in store for Season 4? I sure hope so, and we'll find out sooner rather than later. So this is my first official video of the college football season. Well, kind of had two of them already, but this is like the first real one to kind of set the tone for everything. Like setting the tone for the prediction-wise. So I've done the stream with Ardent Sports about the preseason top 25. I've also did the reaction to the Associated Press top 25 poll that came out just this past Monday. But this is the first real video that I'm doing. And it's going to be my preseason college football playoff predictions. I'm going to name the four teams I think will be making the college football playoff. And then after that, I'll do four long shots. So you're kind of going to get the 4-4. So without further ado, let's get started with the four teams that I think will be making the college football playoff. It's obvious that number one is going to be Alabama, and then number two will be Clemson. So Alabama, Clemson, those are two that I already think are going to make the college football playoff. The third team that I think will be making the college football playoff is Michigan State. I think with Michigan State having 19 returning starters this year, and along with the distractions going on at Ohio State, I think opportunity knocks for the Spartans this year to make the college football playoff. And the fourth team and final team I think we made in the college football playoff, probably just sneaking their way in, the Washington Huskies. So the four teams that I think we made in the college football playoff, the Alabama Crimson Tide, for obvious reasons, they're going to be there. It doesn't really matter. Schedule's pretty much easy. Don't really got any tough opponents now. Lamar Jackson won't be suiting up for Louisville next Saturday night, so it's not like Alabama will have any trouble in that game. Clemson, I think Clemson's the only team that can actually beat Alabama at this point. I think teams like Ohio, Ohio State and Georgia would have a chance, but I think Clemson would have the best chance of anybody beating Alabama. Michigan State, like I said, 19 returning starters, an opportunity knocks in the Big Ten. And Washington, I think they'll be in there. Because if they can get past Auburn, I think their schedule might lean towards them having an easier ticket out of the four teams, really, to make the college football playoff. So, without further ado, let's get to the four long shots. The first long shot, the West Virginia Mountaineers. Now, this could actually be a feel-good, humbling story for Will Grier, the quarterback of West Virginia. The former Florida Gators quarterback that got a year-long suspension by the NCAA for drug use and PED use. Florida kicked him off the team. But he's now in West Virginia, and he's seemed to have humbled himself already, but for him to not only maybe potentially win the Heisman Trophy, but also lead the Mountaineers to the college football playoff, it'd just be a complete turnaround, like a complete humbling story. The second long shot, the Stanford Cardinal. Now, I know some of you are going to think that this isn't necessarily a long shot, but if you base off of the history of Stanford, I know they're consistent winning 8, 9, 10 games a year, but they just can't seem to be in national championship contention at the end of the year. They're going to be dependent on Bryce Love this year. And everybody knows that for a fact. I mean, it wouldn't surprise me if Bryce Love ended up with 2,000 rushing yards this year. I wouldn't be surprised whatsoever because they're going to be that dependent on him. But I think if Stanford can get past Washington and Oregon this year, I like their chances to make the college football playoff. So that's why they're my second long shot. Third long shot, the South Carolina Gamecocks. Jake Bentley returning. I think he's now in that, he's now experienced enough where he could take a team and maybe lead them on an impressive run to start the season. I mean, they have an opportunity to knock out the Georgia Bulldogs in week two at home. So that's something to keep an eye out on. So that's my third long shot. And my final long shot to make the college football playoff, the Florida State Seminoles. Florida State had a miserable year last year. 6-6 season, the heartbreaking loss against, well, it wasn't really heartbreaking. It was a 24-7 defeat, but the heartbreaking part about it was DeAndre Francois suffering a season-ending injury and Jimbo Fisher leaving for Texas A&M, and in comes Willie Taggart. But Willie Taggart, he's really not necessarily going into a bad situation. I know Florida State is one of those schools where they demand improvement right away, but with the roster that he has, with Francois coming back, Cam Akers at running back returning, just those two big pieces right there, it's something that Willie Taggart can work with. And it wouldn't surprise me if they were in national championship contention. So those are my four long shots to make the Caldwell playoff. And that's the end of this video. Like, subscribe, share. Comment the four teams you think will make the Caldwell playoff down below. And also comment maybe three or four long shots you think can make the Caldwell playoff. Anyway, that is it. The next time that I do a video, it will be the week one predictions. I can't wait for that. I'm getting hyped for that. I will see you then.